Welcome to another session of Optical Communication Networks, Unit 4. The title of the Unit 4 is Access Network and Packaging and Cabling of Photonic Components. Nothing but what is the exact design of the optical communication networks? How to design these access networks? What are the considerations you have to take? What are the cabling components at the time of designing a network? We discussed in Unit 4. Here in this Unit 4, the first topic is network architecture. That is, what is meant by access network, how to design architecture of access network based upon some examples we discussed, and HFC, nothing but a hybrid fiber coaxial cable, and FTTC, fiber to the curb or fiber to the cabinet, and what are the different types of optical access networks, what are the deployment considerations, how to upgrading the transmission capacity by using SDM, TDM, and WDM, multiple access techniques. What are the different types of application areas? That is, application areas are interexchange, undersea networks, local exchange networks. These are the discussed in the first part of the fourth unit. And the second part of the fourth unit is packaging and cabling of photonic components. That is, what is meant by photonic packet switching? What is meant by optical time division multiplexing and demultiplexing, and what are the optical logic gates, how it works, and what is the synchronization between transmitter and receiver, and what is meant by broadcasting, at the time of broadcasting, what type of multiple access technique which were used, that is the concept of WDM network, and what are the softwares are used before going to hardware installation of the optical networks by using OTDM testbeds. OTDM testbeds. This is the syllabus regarding the fourth unit. Now let's move to the main topic of fourth unit, introduction. Here in this introduction part, what is the definition of a access network? How to design access network? And what are the examples of the access network we discussed? Here, what is meant access network? Here the access network is nothing but we have to receive services from the service provider. We have to access service from the service providers. Nothing but suppose we are having data access through Google. Nothing but we have to access Google, nothing but we have to take by using internet connection, we have access data from the Google service provider. We have to access these services, whether we are sitting in home or business area, whatever it is. We have to access anyway in the world. Nothing but suppose present, we are directly available, the connections from service area to your home, service area or your business center directly without any intermediate, right? Especially suppose we want high-speed data connection for the business center or offices. At that time, we have to take a direct leased connection from exchange directly by using optical fiber cables or by using either SONET or SDH services or Ethernet-based services for high speed. Suppose we are going for your home. What are the networks we are available in the home? In general, your home having, there are two types of networks. One is telephone network, that is called a plain old telephone service, POTS. Plain old telephone service, POTS service. Other one is, you are using cable connection, that is another network. What is the use of cable network? We have to use the cable network by using analog videos, transmission. Here nothing but for telephone service, you are using twisted pair cables or two-way pair cables. For cable network, we are using coaxial cables for providing services. But today, a single set-top box contains video, that is cable network contains, it is having cable network. It contains internet provided for Wi-Fi connections. It contains telephone network. All are combined together in a single set-top box through optical fiber cables. Instead of different networks, different service providers, a single service provider which gives telephone connection, which gives cable connections, which gives internet connection, or all are connected in a single one. That is the concept is digital subscriber line. Digital subscriber line technology we are using for this purpose. Digital subscriber line technology. For this purpose, we are using one modem. That is set-top box. We are having our home having set-top box. Here, which provides high-speed access networks. High-speed access network. Why you are going for high-speed access network? We have to receive the videos, video on demand, high-definition television, video conferencing. Purpose, we are using high-capacity access networks. Now, we have to discuss about different types of access networks which we are used in real time. Suppose the service type is telephone. The telephone is what type of switched connection. Whenever you want, go for on, then a signal goes and receives signal. What is the downstream and what is upstream? What is the downstream from access service provider to home is the downstream. Upstream nothing but home to service provider. Both are having a bandwidth of 4 kilohertz. Next service is ISDN. What is going to ISDN? ISDN is nothing but integrated service digital network. This is also why you are going for ISDN concepts. In general telephone connection, we are using only for transmission of voice only. But instead of the same network we are using telephone network, just we have to connect modem, then it is called as ISDN. The ISDN provides both voice and data service. This is also switching type with a downstream bandwidth is 144 kbps speed. For upstream is also 144 kbps. Next one is broadcast video. What is going to be broadcasting? Broadcasting is nothing but you have to transmit data from one transmitter to many receivers. Nothing but it having only downstream only. Nothing but radio broadcasting. You have to receive a signal from radio station to your homes. There is no upstream. There is no reply. TV broadcasting. Nothing but the type is broadcasting. The downstream is 6 megahertz frequency or 2 to 6 Mbps speed. There is no upstream. Nothing but there is no reply in the broadcasting. Next, interactive video. Interactive video, nothing but also switched condition. The downstream is 6 Mbps. The upstream is small. That is uploading is small, but downloading is high. Next, internet access is also switched. And it is a few Mbps for downstream, for upstream is small initially. And video conferencing, it is also switched connection. And the downstream is 6 Mbps, upstream also 6 Mbps. For business services, it is also service type, switched type of service. And with downstream bandwidth is 1.5 Mbps to 10 Gbps. For upstream also 1.5 Mbps to 10 Gbps. This is about these types of services and what is the downstream and upstream bandwidths. Yes, see this one. About the services have the type. We are using is switched and broadcasting. Switched and broadcasting. Here, what is the bandwidth requirement? For this bandwidth requirement only, we have to transmit and receive the signals. What about for the general telephone connection? We are using only for voice transmission, which requires only kilohertz. But video streaming in terms of megahertz. And what is meant symmetric or asymmetric? The symmetric is nothing but two-way transmission of signal. For asymmetric is only one way. And broadcasting is nothing but we have to transmit from one to many. One to many. This is about the introduction of this access network, which are the different types of services which are used in real time. Next, we are going for access network architecture overview. Access network architecture overview. Here, see this one. The access networks contains hub. Next, the hub is connected to many number of remote nodes. And each remote node contains many of the NIUs, nothing but network interface units. Network interface units. Here, what is meant by hub? What is meant by remote node? What is meant by NIU, network interface units? I think, but suppose we are going for a telephone, we have to take example of telephone network. In the telephone network, what is meant by hub? Hub is nothing but telephone exchange or central office or local exchange. Local exchange. This local exchange is connected to many number of remote nodes. What is meant by remote node? Remote node is nothing but feeder circuits. I think, but yeah, all of you, I think most of all of you see the in roadsides having a telephone boxes. The telephone boxes have a number of connections from the homes. That is the feeder circuits. From feeder circuits to NIUs, network interface units, nothing but these network interface units are available in your home, the connections. Here, each hub may be connected to number of RNs. All RNs are connected to number of NIUs. The RN is also called the feeder network. Feeder network. Here, the NIUs also called the distribution network. See this one, RN is also called as a feeder network. NIUs also called as a distribution network. Here, what is meant by distribution network? Here, the distribution network works in the principle of two categories, broadcast and switched connection. Here, what is meant by broadcasting? Here, the broadcasting is nothing but the RN broadcasts the data it receives from the feeder network to all NIUs. That is broadcast. There is no reply connection. But in switching network, the RN processes the data coming and sends possibility, separate the data streams in different NIUs. That is, I have to send data to NIUs and receive the data from the NIUs and separate from forwarding and reversing. Here, there are basically classifying of access networks based upon the feeder network. Now we are going for what is the classification of access network by using feeder network. First one, the feeder network could assign each NIUs its own dedicated path. Nothing but the feeder network or RN network are connected to a dedicated path to your home. And each dedicated path contains bandwidth, fixed bandwidth. The second one is the feeder network or remote node contains number of NIUs by single path. That is, the first type is remote nodes having number of different connections to all NIUs. Suppose one remote node, 10 NIUs. From remote node to 10 NIUs having different path, and 10 paths is there. For each path having a dedicated bandwidth. But in second type, from RN to 10 NIUs having single channel. That is single path to connect it to all NIUs. By using multiple access technique, we have to sharing the bandwidth. Sharing the bandwidth. Here, see this one. The best example here. Suppose broadcast or switch broadcasting network. Where is the broadcast network we are using? Cable TV. Suppose you see this one, cable TV. Nothing but from your cable operator to your home. Having a coaxial cable, optical fiber cable. You have to share the same information to all home. Same video can be moved from cable operator to your home, from many number of homes in the city. A dedicated path is wireless personal area network. Next, switcher connection is nothing but switch where exactly we are switching. Telephone connection is a switching. Digital subscriber loop is a switching. And wireless personal area network switching. Now we are going for to discuss different examples related to access network. The first one is the telephone network. See this one. In your city having a central office, that is telephone exchange. Or other name for telephone exchange is central office CO. From central office CO to your home having landline connection by the twisted pair cables. Twisted pair cable. Yes, it is from center office to each one having a separate path. Yes, a separate pair, a point to point connection from both upstream and downstream of five transmission is 4 kilohertz. 4 kilohertz. This is about telephone network. The second one is cable network. Here, what is the use of cable network from your home? From your city having a cable operator, from cable operator to your home connection cable by the coaxial cable. Coaxial cable. What is used here? Where is the coaxial cable? The coaxial cable, which is used to transmit high frequency video signals. High frequency video signals. Here, what is the bandwidth which we are used for this cable network is 50, starting from 50 megahertz to 550 megahertz, which supports 78 AM vestigial sideband television signals. 78 AM type amplitude modulation vestigial sideband television signals. Television signals. Here, for each cable network can be connects from 500 to 2000 homes. 2000 homes. Here, this type of network is called the hybrid fiber coaxial. What is the hybrid combination? Combination of optical fiber cable and coaxial cable network. How it can be possible in cable network? Now let's move to the figure. See this one. Head end. Nothing but head end is nothing but which provides. Anything but cable operator. Suppose we are go for a big city. It is having a big city. Suppose around 20,000 houses in that city having only one cable operator, main cable operator is nothing but head end. But different areas having another cable operator. We are taking service from main head end to another cable operator. That is called the remote node. From this head end to remote nodes having, we are using fiber, optical fibers. But remote nodes to your homes, we are using coaxial cables. See this one, this is nothing but amplifiers. Where you are using amplifiers, after every 10 to 20 homes, automatically the signal strength is weak. To increase that signal strength, we are using amplifiers for every 20 to 30 homes. This is nothing but tap connections. What is the tap connection? The tap connections are used to connect TVs connections. This is about cable network. Nothing but what is the difference between telephone and cable network? The telephone network having less bandwidth, but cable network high bandwidth. That is the telephone network having a kilohertz. That is 4 kilohertz telephone network, but cable network 550 megahertz. The telephone network is called a switching type of network. The cable network is called the broadcasting network. Next, the third one of the example is ISDN, Integrated Services Digital Network. What is the use of ISDN? What is the use of general telephone network? In general telephone network supports only voice, but once we have to convert the general telephone network to ISDN network, which supports both voice and data transmission, which provides 144 kbps speed bandwidth. This is here the type of channel which we are using it, twisted pair cable only. Next example is DSL, Digital Subscriber Loop. Here, what is the use of Digital Subscriber Loop? Which using the same existing twisted pair infrastructures, but which provides more bandwidth than the ISDN. That is, upgrading version of the ISDN is called the DSL. One is satellites. It is also one of the access network. Here, what is the use of satellites? It is a direct broadcasting system by using geosynchronous satellites to broadcast few hundred channels to individual homes. Nothing but here we are using, instead of cable connection, we are using that is D2H services, Vodafone D2H service, Airtel, and Sun TV having, and D2H different types of services. This is nothing but we have to broadcast the services by using satellites. Right. Next one is wireless access. Wireless access, instead of using two wire pair, coaxial cable, optical fiber, a wireless connection between two transmitter and receiver. That is about wireless access. Here, automatically in wireless access, the infrastructure should be less, and the infrastructure cost also very less. For example of this wireless access system is multi-channel, multi-point distribution service. Multi-channel, multi-point distribution service. The second one is local multi-point distribution service. Nothing but here multi-channel, multi-point. Nothing but you can suppose I'll go for best one is cellular network. Having multiple channels are available, multiple services we are taking, and multiple users can access the data. Here, see this one. This is having a. It is from 33 channels, and with the 6 megahertz. 33 channels, each having 6 megahertz frequency. The total is 2 to 3 gigahertz band. That is the bandwidth is available is 2 to 3 gigahertz band. This can be divided into 33 channels, each channel having 6 megahertz, which supports up to 15 to 55 kilometers wireless network, wireless range. Second one is local multi-point distribution service, LMDS. Total is 28 gigahertz. This can be divided into number of channels, which each channel is 1.3 gigahertz, which supports a maximum range is 3 to 5 kilometers. These are the some of the examples of access network. Do you have any query? Type your query in the chat box. Thank you very much for attending today's class.